In a distant, remote corner of the galaxy, the Grand Councilwoman listened to a scientist plead his case. Dr. Jumba described his illegal creation.
What you see before you is the first of a new species. I call it Experiment 626.
He is bulletproof, fireproof, and can think faster than supercomputer. He can see in the dark and move objects 3,000 times his size. His only instinct to destroy everything he touches!
Captain Gantu grew tired of Jumba's antics and had him arrested. The Grand Councilwoman then ordered Captain Gantu to get rid of 626 as well. Gantu's crew prepared to escort 626 to a far-off asteroid by securing him in a holding cell on a transport ship. Just as they took off, 626 broke out.
Red alert! Seal off the deck!
The guards tried to stop 626 with plasma blasters, but he charged the guards head-on. In the chaos, 626 seemed to vanish. A frantic search came up empty.
I don't think he's on the ship anymore.
Confirmed. He's taken a police cruiser.
Hyperdrive activated.
Engaged his H-drive!
Back at Galactic Control, they tracked 626 as he hurtled toward an unfamiliar part of the galaxy. A control operator pinpointed Stitch's destination.
A planet called Earth.
A giant overhead screen showed the blue planet. The Grand Councilwoman smiled.
He won't survive in water. His molecular density is too great.
Then, tiny islands suddenly appeared in 626's path.
We have to gas the planet.
Agent Pleakley, an expert on planet Earth, rushed in.
Earth is a protected wildlife reserve. We've been using it to rebuild the mosquito population, which, need I remind you, is an endangered species.
Rather than destroy Earth, Jumba was paroled so he could anticipate his creation's actions and swiftly apprehend 626.
626 will not come easily. Maybe a direct hit from plasma cannon might stun him long enough to...
But the planet's a delicate planet!
Who's gonna control him?
Pleakley was given the job. On a small island of Hawaii, a young girl, Lilo, swam in the rolling waves. When she realized that she was late for hula dance class, Lilo dashed from the water and tried, unsuccessfully, to slip into class unnoticed by the teacher.
Lilo, why are you all wet?
It's sandwich day. Every Thursday I take Pudge the Fish a peanut butter sandwich.
The other students rolled their eyes, and one girl, Myrtle, taunted Lilo.
You're crazy.
Lilo lunged at Myrtle, but the teacher caught her.
Lilo, maybe we should call your sister.
No, I'll be good. I want to dance. I practiced. I just want to dance.
After class, Lilo forgot to wait for her older sister, Nani, and walked home alone. Not finding Lilo at the hula school, Nani rushed home to find that Lilo had locked herself inside.
Lilo! Open the door, Lilo! The social worker's gonna be here any minute.
Cobra Bubbles arrived in time to see Nani breaking into her own house. He was evaluating Nani as a guardian for Lilo. Lilo put on her best smile and recited the answers she and Nani had practiced.
I'm adjusted. I eat four food groups and look both ways before crossing the street and take long naps.
Suddenly, Lilo mixed up what she was supposed to say. Cobra was not impressed. He gave Lilo his business card.
Call me next time you're left here alone.
As he left, Cobra turned to Nani.
In case you're wondering, this did not go well.
Nani was upset with Lilo. The two sisters had a big fight.
Do you want to be taken away?
Later that night, Lilo questioned Nani when she returned to Lilo's bedroom.
We're a broken family, aren't we?
No.
Maybe a little. Maybe a lot.
I'll tell you what.
If you promise not to fight anymore, I promise not to yell at you. Except on special occasions.
Suddenly, Lilo saw a shooting star and pushed Nani out of her bedroom so that she could make a secret wish.
It's me again. I need someone to be my friend. Someone who won't run away. Maybe send me an angel. The nicest angel you have.
Hearing Lilo's wish, Nani sensed how lonely Lilo was and that she could use a playmate. Lilo did not know that the shooting star was actually 626's spaceship, crash landing in a field of sugarcane. 626 emerged from the wreckage and walked onto the road, where he was mowed over by a convoy of trucks. The spikes on his back caused all their tires to burst. The drivers got out to investigate.
There it is. It's jammed under a fender.
Next thing he knew, 626 woke up in a kennel without his blaster or uniform. Within seconds, he escaped from his kennel cage and sneaked out of the building, passing unnoticed by Lilo and Nani, who were arriving at the kennel to adopt a new friend. Outside, a scorching energy blast narrowly missed 626. He dashed back to his cage. Just then, Lilo entered to pick out her new pet.
Are there any animals in here?
Recognizing that he would never get out of the kennel alive on his own, 626 quickly concealed his back spikes, extra set of legs, and antennae to look more like a dog. Lilo picked him and proudly showed him to Nani. She was shocked.
What is that thing? Does it have to be this dog?
Yes, he's good. I can tell. His name is Stitch.
I want to buy him.
Can I borrow $2?
As Lilo and Stitch left the kennel together, Jumba leapt to capture 626, but Pleakley stopped him.
You can't shoot, and you can't be seen. Look at you!
You look like a monster.
We have to blend in.
Nani had to go to work, so Lilo introduced Stitch to her world. It was all foreign to him. Stitch kept trying to escape while Lilo tried to keep him out of trouble. Jumba, still trailing them, was amused as Stitch grew increasingly frustrated. That night, Lilo and Stitch ate at the luau where Nani worked. Lilo showed Stitch her drawing.
This is you. This is your badness level. It's unusually high for someone your size. We have to fix that.
Lilo barely got her words out before Stitch was off trying to steal food from a woman's purse. It turned out to be a Jumba trap.
Look what I find! Get the stripes!
Pleakley tried, but Stitch escaped again. He caused such a commotion that Nani got fired. Lilo eagerly brought Stitch home.
This is a great home. You'll like it a lot.
Stitch proceeded to destroy anything in his path. Lilo objected when Nani disciplined Stitch.
Be careful of the little angel.
It's not an angel, Lilo. I don't even think it's a dog. We just have to take him back.
He was an orphan and we adopted him. What about Ohana?
Huh? Ohana means family. Family means nobody gets left behind.
Or forgotten. I know. I hate it when you use Ohana against me.
Lilo took Stitch up to her room. Stitch found an old photo under Lilo's pillow.
Be careful of that! You don't touch this! Don't ever touch it!
Later, Stitch found a book about an ugly duckling. He was curious about it. Lilo explained that in the end, the duckling was happy because he knew where he belonged. The next day, Nani was startled when Cobra appeared at her door.
Heard you lost your job.
Stitch ran by and threw a book, hitting Cobra squarely on the head.
Hey!
As he left, Cobra told Nani that his patience with their situation was wearing thin.
The next time I see this dog, I expect it to be a model citizen.
All that day, Nani dragged Lilo and Stitch along as she interviewed for jobs. Lilo used the time to teach Stitch about her hero.
Elvis Presley was a model citizen. I've compiled a list of his traits for you to practice.
However, as Stitch excitedly practiced such things as dancing and playing guitar, he disrupted every interview. When the day drew to a close, Nani still had not gotten a job. Lilo, Stitch, and Nani were sitting quietly on the beach when Nani's friend David walked up.
Hey, Lilo. How's it, Nani?
We've been having a bad day.
Hey, I might not be a doctor, but I know that there's no better cure for a sour face than a couple of boards and some choice waves. What do you think?
Nani agreed. So they all joined David in the sparkling water. Each new wave carried them farther and farther away from their troubles. Despite his dislike of water, even Stitch became captivated by this sport, and when they returned to shore, he dragged over a surfboard, asking for another ride. Meanwhile, Pleakley was on his space communicator, updating the Grand Councilwoman on the status of their mission.
Things are going well. I think they're going well. Jumbo, aren't they going well?
I would have expected you back by now with 626 in hand.
As Lilo, Stitch, and Nani headed out into the water, Jumba saw an opportunity.
Hang up. We are going swimming.
As the trio surfed through the green barrel of a wave, Jumba swam up from underneath. The white water of the crashing wave hid Jumba as he pulled Stitch beneath the tide. Nani and Lilo surfaced and looked around. Stitch struggled frantically and broke out of Jumba's grasp. Before he could reach the surface, he ran out of air and started to sink. Fortunately, David was nearby searching for him. He rescued the waterlogged Stitch and carried him up the beach to where Lilo and Nani were waiting.
He's unconscious, but I think he's alive.
Soon, Stitch exploded back to life. Disoriented and fighting, Nani pulled Lilo out of the way, but then noticed that Cobra had observed the whole fiasco. She tried to explain.
This isn't what it looks like.
Cobra just shook his head.
I know you're trying, Nani, but you need to think about what's best for Lilo. Even if it removes you from the picture.
Defeated, Nani took Lilo in her arms and started home. David felt heartbroken.
You know, I really believed they had a chance. Then you came along.
Stitch felt hurt and guilty because he knew that he was to blame. That night, Nani tried to tell Lilo that she was going to be taken away. Nani just couldn't find the strength to do it. Stitch returned to Lilo's bedroom and uncovered the photo underneath Lilo's pillow. It was a picture of Lilo, Nani, and their parents. When Lilo walked into the room, she saw Stitch.
That's us before. Our family's little now. But if you want, you could be part of it. You could be our baby, and we'd raise you to be good.
Stitch took the ugly duckling book and started walking toward the window.
Ohana means family. Family means nobody gets left behind. But if you want to leave, you can. I'll remember you, though.
Stitch walked deep into the forest, desperately hoping to find his own family.
lost.
The next morning, Jumba and Pleakley finally made it back to shore. The enraged Grand Councilwoman called on the space phone.
I have lost patience with you both. Consider yourselves fired and prison-bound. Your incompetence is nothing short of unspeakable.
Pleakley was shocked, but Jumba was excited.
No! We'll do it my way!
Your way?
Wait!
Meanwhile, the Grand Councilwoman notified Captain Gontu.
The mission is in jeopardy. This could be your chance to redeem yourself. How soon will you be prepared to leave?
Immediately.
Jumba caught up to Stitch in the middle of the forest. Stitch told Jumba that he was waiting for his family.
You don't have one. I made you. Oh. You're built to destroy. You can never belong.
Don't run!
Back at the house, Lilo told Nani about Stitch.
Stitch left. It's good he's gone. He didn't want to be here anyway.
Nani knew it was time for the difficult talk.
Lilo, sometimes you try your hardest, but things don't work out the way you want them to. Sometimes things have to change, and maybe sometimes they're for the better, even if...
Nani was interrupted when David arrived, announcing that he'd found her a job. Nani excitedly turned to Lilo.
Lilo? Baby, this is really important. I'm gonna be right back. Lock the door and don't answer it for anyone, okay?
Mwah. Seconds after Nani left, Lilo was shocked to see Stitch burst through the dog door. He tried to sneak Lilo out of the house, but Jumba rushed in. Pleakley arrived to see Jumba and Stitch fully engaged in a reckless battle. Lilo ran to the phone.
Hello, Bubble Bubbles? Aliens are attacking my house.
Pleakley was horrified.
No! No aliens! There's no need to alert the authorities!
Stitch found Jumba's plasma blaster, but before he could use it, Jumba plugged the end with a carrot. Pleakley grabbed Lilo and ran out of the house. Jumba's plasma blaster exploded, blowing the house up with it. In town, Nani graciously thanked her new boss when sirens stopped her speech. A fire truck raced up the road toward her house. She ran home to find the remains of the house in smoldering ruins and Lilo safe in the arms of Cobra Bubbles. When Cobra saw Nani coming, he gently put Lilo in his car. Nani pleaded with him.
Don't do this.
One who understands her. You take that away, she won't stand a chance.
She needs me.
Is this what she needs?
While they argued, Lilo slipped out and ran into the forest. Lilo. Stitch crawled from the rubble of the house and saw Lilo's scorched family photo. Knowing that this was Lilo's most valued possession, he grabbed it and went to find her in the woods. Lilo ran as fast as she could, trying to get as far away as possible. In her path, Stitch popped out from the bushes and presented Lilo's half-burned family picture.
You ruined everything.
Stitch revealed his true self as he bared his back spikes, antennae, and extra legs.
You're one of them? Get out of here, Stitch.
Without warning, Gontu's net burst out of the bushes, entangling Lilo and Stitch. Nani arrived just in time to see Gontu load Lilo and Stitch onto his ship. Stitch worked his way out of the containment pod, but fell from the ship as it took off with Lilo still trapped inside. Seeing that Stitch was an alien, Nani confronted him.
Okay, talk. I know you had something to do with this. Now where is Lilo? Talk!
Before Stitch could answer, a plasma blast struck him. Stitch was stunned long enough for Jumba and Pleakley to contain him. Nani was shocked to see more aliens.
Where's Lilo?
Jumba was unsure if he should interact with this human.
Sorry, we do not know anyone by this...
Lilo! She's a little girl this big! She has black hair and brown eyes and she hangs around with that thing!
Bring her back.
See, problem is, we're just here for him.
So she's gone?
Stitch shuffled over to Nani and spoke the words Lilo had taught him.
Ohana means family. Family means nobody
gets left behind.
Or forgotten.
Everyone piled onto a motorcycle and raced off to Jumba and Pleakley's hidden spaceship. Once in the air, Jumba used his ship to bump Gantu's and sent it spinning out of control. Stitch blew the door off of Jumba's ship, was sucked out into the sky, and landed on Gantu's windshield.
Little savage, get off my ship!
Lilo watched helplessly as Gantu blasted Stitch off the speeding ship. Stitch was knocked out briefly, but was energized when he heard Lilo's call. Just then, Stitch saw a gas tanker driving towards him. He jumped in, scared away the driver, and drove it into a pool of molten lava. When the tanker exploded, it rocketed Stitch toward Gantu's ship. He crashed through the windshield and rescued Lilo.
You came back.
Nobody gets left behind.
The ship splashed into the ocean. And David, who was surfing nearby, helped everyone ashore. There, they were met by Cobra and a fleet of aliens. The Grand Councilwoman prepared to take Stitch back to prison at once. To her amazement, Stitch wanted to say goodbye to Lilo. The Grand Councilwoman demanded an explanation.
This is my family. I found it all on my own. It's little and broken, but still good.
Cobra stepped in.
Lilo, didn't you buy that thing at the shelter?
Hey! 3 days ago, I bought a Stitch at the shelter. I paid $2 for it. See the snap? If you take them, you're stealing.
The Grand Councilwoman made a new proclamation.
Take note of this. This creature has been sentenced to life in exile. A sentence that shall be henceforth served out here. On Earth.
Nani, Lilo, and Stitch were now an official family. The spirit of Ohana proved that anyone can belong. Even a little six-legged alien named Stitch.